Hi, Srijit. He is our DevOps engineer from OlinData. I will pass to him to start the webinar in another 1 minute. So if anyone of the audience, you have questions or you have the question, you can actually type in the question bar under the post, and then or you can raise hand, but our speaker will answer your questions towards the end of the webinar.
Hi everyone. Let's start with today's webinar. Today we are going to talk about centralizing syslog with Filebeat, Logstash and Elasticsearch using Puppet. I'll start with a little bit about my name is Srijit Nair. I started my career as a Java developer, then I turned to system admin and currently working as DevOps developer and consultant for OlinData India. This is the overview we are covering today. We'll be talking about what is Puppet, and then we'll try to understand what is Filebeat, Logstash and Elasticsearch. Then we'll see how to set up Filebeat, Logstash and Elasticsearch using Puppet. Then we can have some hands-on and a demo on how things works and gels together and how we get the output. Then we can move to questions, of course. Okay, so to start with, let me tell you that this is not more about Puppet. This is more on Elasticsearch, Logstash and Filebeat, but we are using Puppet to configure and manage that. So let us start with a little bit about Puppet. Puppet is a very well-known configuration management tool. It scales with whatever your servers are. If you have one or more than 20,000 servers, it scales very well and performs almost all the platforms you have. And it has both open source and enterprise version. We'll see why we are using Puppet for this setup. So this is a typical Puppet architecture. There are agents your servers are mostly called agents. So the Puppet agent will reside on the servers, like if you have web server, app server or database, any server, there will be Puppet agent sitting on it and which will talk to Puppet master. And in the same way, configuration will be managed on all the servers. Puppet the configuration will be kept in your remote repository or on Puppet master, and then you can push the configuration on different agents according to the servers. So these are the components that we are going to talk about today. This is how the whole flow of component works. Like I said, that Puppet agent will be sitting on all servers. In this case, we have Filebeat, which will be used to ship logs to Logstash. So every server, like if you have an app server and you want to monitor system logs or any logs on that server, then you'll have to configure Filebeat on that server, which will push those logs to a different component. In this case, it's on Logstash, and from Logstash we'll push it to Elasticsearch, and then from Elasticsearch you can use your data for any purpose, like enterprise search, analytics or monitoring. Here Logstash, we are using Logstash for processing and indexing logs. And for Elasticsearch, we are using Elasticsearch for storing logs and for fast access of logs. We'll see each of these components in details now. So we'll start with Filebeat first. So Filebeat is a very lightweight component that Elastic has come up with. Previously, they were having a component called Logstash Forwarder, which was doing the same thing for them. But now they have came up with Filebeat. Filebeat is as I said, it's very lightweight as compared to Logstash Forwarder now. And if you go to the Elastic website, you'll see a lot of beats there, pop beat, which is used and so which is used to monitor or push the logs of a different component. Like if you want to monitor the performance of system, there are different beats. So particularly here we'll talk about Filebeat, which is used to forward the data to a data, or you can say logs in this case, to a different component. Here what we are using here is Logstash. So the second component is Logstash. Here we are using Logstash for centralizing data and processing it on a single platform or on a single plane. Like the Logstash contains three parts. The first is input and filter, then output. So input will define that what input is coming to Logstash. In our case, we have Filebeat. If you want to configure a different file or a CSV file or any other component, then that will be configured in input. So input will tell from where the logs are coming. Filter is a very important part for Logstash, but we'll talk about output first and then we'll go to filter. Output is, as you said, decision maker. So we'll be sending, after processing the logs, we'll be sending the logs to a different component, like in this case, it's Elasticsearch. So that needs to be configured here in output. And you can configure multiple output for Logstash, like if you want to forward it to Elasticsearch, or if you want to forward it to Isinga or any other server, then you can configure multiple output and do the same. So the only thing that's left is filter here. Filter is very important part because Logstash is mainly used for data processing. When I say data processing, suppose you have syslogs, and there are a lot of syslog has a lot of junk line which you may not be interested in. So filter will help you to get your important data or the data that you're looking for from the logs and forward it to output. So suppose if you have 100 lines and only 10 of those make sense for you, then you can filter out those 10 and forward it to output so that you will not get a lot of data there on output component. The third and last component we're talking about is Elasticsearch. Elasticsearch is an open source server written in Java, mainly known for fast retrieval of data. So it's almost real-time data. Whatever you search, you get it in real-time. As I said, that we'll be using Puppet to manage and install these components. We are using Puppet modules available on puppetforge.puppetlabs.com. Puppet Forge, people who don't know, let me tell you that puppetforge.puppetlabs.com is kind of a repository for Puppet modules. There are hundreds of modules for everything. Like you, for Elasticsearch, there will be different modules created by different users. You can use the modules in your code if you want it, or you can modify it and use it in your own way. So it's like you don't need to write the whole code for something. You'll get a module there and you can use it or you can modify it. These three are the modules that we are using here: Elasticsearch, Logstash, and Filebeat. These three modules are we are using it. So this is the path of those modules, and this is the module name. So module name consists of, first is module user, the user who has created it, and second is module name. So this module is created by Elasticsearch user called Elasticsearch, and module name is Elasticsearch. Same goes with Logstash and Filebeat. So now let us move to a little bit of coding stuff here. We'll set up each component one by one using Puppet. So first of all, we'll start with Elasticsearch. As I said, that we'll be using Elasticsearch module. So first of all, for using a module, it needs to be installed on the master, because when you install it, it will use the module. When you install it on the component, like if you have an Elasticsearch server and you install Elasticsearch on the server, it will look up for the modules on master. So always remember that Puppet modules are installed on master. So first we'll be installing Elasticsearch module on Puppet master using this command. And as I said, that it's built on Java, so the prerequisite is Java. If we do include Java in our code, it will install automatically the latest version of Java for us. This is the way we need to configure a class to install Elasticsearch. Like here it is given that class Elasticsearch and version, whatever version we define here, Elasticsearch will look up into its repository and download that version for me, for us. If we want, we can configure a local path here if we have the installable, and then we can do it that in that way also. So this was the installation part. If we want to configure it, the method uses Elasticsearch instance. This will be the instance name, whatever you give here. It will be instance name, and then you can pass different hash here, configuration for default initializations and data directory. We'll come to this while we have a demo after this. Second is setting up Logstash. As I said, that we'll be installing modules on master using this command, puppet module install and module name. So for installing Logstash, we'll have this code. We'll use the class called Logstash, and there's a dependency to install Java. Then we can say Java install 2 and ensure present. Ensure present will make sure that Logstash is installed on the server. Now when we come to the configuration part, the method that is used to configure the Logstash is Logstash config file. So config file, you can configure a Logstash configuration file using there are two ways given here in this module particularly. So one is you can configure it with a template. Template will have the configuration written in it, and it's mostly in ERB format, so you can have variables there and change its value, or you can pass its value from Hira file or any other file. And second one is source. You just need to define the source file, mostly static ones, and you define it here, and the source file, the file is taken from source, and it's configured wherever the Logstash server is configured. Okay, so the next component is we will talk a little bit about the Logstash configuration file. As I said in introduction, that it has mainly three parts: input, filter, and output. Let's see what these things mean here. Input here is beats. As I said, we'll be using Filebeat. Okay. One thing I'd like to point out here is that Logstash support lots of plugins. So these components are mostly used as plugins. So if you want to use beats, you will have to download the plugin for beats and use it. So there's a command to install Logstash plugins. By that you'll have to download the beats plugin, and then Rock plugin and Elasticsearch plugin, HDAuth plugin, and then you can use it. So here in input beats, we have configured beats as input, and we have configured the port as 5044 and type log. When we come to filter, we have type called syslog beat. We'll come to this, what is type and how we can use this. We'll come to this when we do the actual demo. Third one is grok match. Grok is a filter in Logstash by which you can parse each line of the message, and you can assign it to a variable. Like if you have a log line which is having a lot of details in it, you can assign each of the values of line to a different variable, like IP to a variable named IP and response code to a variable called response code, like that. So grok is very heavily used in Logstash filter part. So the third part of the file is output. As I said, that we can configure multiple output for Logstash. Here we are configuring Elasticsearch and std out. So the data will go to Elasticsearch, and at the same time it will go to the std out the console also. Next part is setting up Filebeat. In the same way, we'll be installing modules from Puppet Forge. Configuring Filebeat is the way there where we'll configure the output, or we'll configure the log path which need to be sent. Like this way, here we are installing Filebeat. We'll install Filebeat with output as Logstash, and we can give hostname. If we have more than one hostname, we can add those hostname here inside this array. And enable true means this output will be enabled. If you want this output to be disabled, just making it false, and the output will not be sent to Logstash anymore. Okay, the next part is prospector part. Prospector is prospector is very important part here, because if you want to monitor more than one files, like in this case we are monitoring where log messages. If you have some application specific files, you can add one more Filebeat prospector and configure a different log there and name it here. So as I said in previous slide that we were checking if the source is, or if the type is syslogbeat. Let me move back. So we were checking here if type is syslogbeat. It comes from here. Log type is syslogbeat. So this is mainly used if you want to see logs for a single component. Like if you have a Tomcat web server, you say log type Tomcat. And if you want to see only Tomcat logs, then you can filter it out based of that and grok the message pattern using grok. Okay, so now we'll move to demo a little bit. I'll show how this code work on servers. I am already logged into my Puppet Master, my Logstash server, and on my Elasticsearch server. First of all, I'll show you the output. Yeah, first of all, I'll show you the output. So this is the output that's coming on the Filebeat server. On the Logstash server. We are monitoring the syslog on master server. You can use it to monitor any server, but right now I'm here monitoring master server. So if I say logger, this is a test line. This will write this line in syslogs, and we can see we'll get the log here with all the details coming up for it here. See, like this, we have message and we have timestamp at what time we are getting that message. We have a source, we have type on which we were checking the conditions, syslogbeat. In the same way, we can use grok patterns to filter out the different things. Like if you want to filter out the timestamp coming up here, you can use the grok pattern to filter out timestamp, and you can create a variable and assign that timestamp to that variable, and wherever you forward the data, like in this case we are forwarding it to Elasticsearch, you'll get a variable there with the same name, and its value can be retrieved from that variable. So let's first see the Filebeat configuration on master. We have a filebeat.yaml file here. So this is coming from the Filebeat installation code, where we have defined what will be the output there. As I said, I'll be configuring only one output to Logstash. So this is the Logstash server name and port, and as I have enabled it too, so we are getting the output on Logstash server with that. The second part for this was the prospectors. So the module create prospector inside a folder called confd, which is in etc file confd. So we have configured only one prospector, which was syslog. So this is monitoring, this is the syslog file, which is where log messages. And these are the default options because I haven't changed anything. The module gives you the flexibility to change these options. If you want to change these, you can change this. This is the document type which we are getting there, type on which we are making decisions about the logs. So this was on the Filebeat server. If we move to the Logstash server, we can see the configuration on Logstash server. We are using, as we have seen the slide of slide which has the logstash.config file details. So we have three parts, input, filter and output. Input is same, beats here, and we are using grok pattern for syslog base. This is, there are set of grok patterns which are already defined in Logstash, which, so syslog base is one of them which is used to grok the message format of syslog. And third is output. Output, I have configured two output, Elasticsearch and std out. Third part is Elasticsearch server. So this is the instance name which I created, the Elasticsearch instance. If you go inside that, you can see the configuration file, which is elasticsearch.yaml. If I open it, we can see the configuration, like we have given it as a name of ES01, so it's taken the name ES01. This is the default parameter for this path. We have given it the name of Elasticsearch, this is the host name actually, and this is the port on which Elasticsearch will run. I'll also show the code that we have used for these configurations on master. So if I go inside the manifests, I have the files which is used to configure these components on different servers. Like if we start with Elasticsearch first, as you can see, as I said that Java is needed for Elasticsearch as it's built on Java. So we are including Java, installing it. I'm calling class Elasticsearch and defining these parameters for managing repository and repository version. So this will install Elasticsearch and this will configure the instance. As we saw, the instance name is ES-01. So we are creating an instance called ES-01, saying ensure present. And here we are giving a configuration hash in which we will define the network host and the other parameters. If you want more than one instance, then you can add one more instance and configure it in a cluster, and you need to define the cluster here in Elasticsearch class. So this was for Elasticsearch. If we see the configuration or the public file for Logstash, don't get confused too much looking into this, because Logstash config file is breaking everything and giving you the power to have all small components, and this will combine together to make one file that we have seen, logstash.config. As you can see here, I'm using class Logstash to install it, and I'm giving the package URL. The package URL contains exactly which version I want to install of Logstash. In this case, I'm using data. I'm getting data from Hira. People who don't know Hira, say Hira is a component of a Puppet which works with Puppet to externalize the data. So you can keep it in a Hira file and use it directly on class. So the best thing about it is that you don't need to have a static variable like this. You can have a dynamic value. You can set it up from outside from a Hira file, and it will replicate here, and you can use it directly here. So I have configured here input beats. So we'll see these files once we are done with this file. So I have configured input beats. I have configured a filter, and I have configured an output called Elasticsearch and configured an output called std out. As I said that the Everything, every component we are including in input, filter and output will be a plugin. So here we are installing those plugins. I've already downloaded the plugin and kept it in this path so that Puppet will grab it from this path and put it on the Filebeat server, sorry, on the Logstash server. So this was the code for Logstash. We'll see the Filebeat configuration also. So this is the Filebeat configuration. This class installs Filebeat and configure output as Logstash. Again, you can add a couple of hosts here if you are. Then this is the prospector part. We are only configuring syslog. That's why I have configured syslog path and the path to a syslog. If you have more, if you have like more than, if you want to configure something else, then you can add this thing here and with a different name and with different path and probably a different log type also. So this was the Puppet files for installing and configuring these components. If we go back to the templates, these are the templates that I am calling there. I'll open one to explain it. So this says that beats and this is the ERB file. So you can pass these parameters from an external resource. So the port value and type is coming from a Hira file. So it's not coming. It's like wherever you are calling it, you are getting it from a Hira file and assigning it to a local variable where you are calling it, and then from that local variable, it's being passed to this ERB file. And the other part is files. As I said that I have downloaded the plugins for this. These are the plugins: Beats, Grok, and Elasticsearch. So I have downloaded and kept it on master. So whenever we configure a Logstash server, these plugins are moved to those, copied to those servers and used there. So this was the demo part. And the next part is questions. If you have any questions, you can write it in the questions section. Or you can mail me at srijit@olindata.com. I will try my best to find a solution for them. If you have any questions. Okay, Manu has a question, says that he's asking that what are the advantages of using Filebeat. Advantage of using Filebeat is that it's very lightweight component. So if you add, because as I said that if you want to ship your logs from a particular server to Logstash or any other server, then you need to configure an agent there. So in this case, Filebeat is acting as an agent there. And before Filebeat, they were using Logstash forwarder, but Filebeat is very less. It uses less memory and resources, and it's very lightweight. So that's why Filebeat is a better option among those agents which can ship logs.
Yeah, this is Walter here, by the way. One extra advantage of the Filebeat technology is that if you want and you have a very small setup, you could potentially ship your logs straight from Filebeat to Elasticsearch and going around Logstash. In any setup, we would recommend to use Logstash, because Logstash is where you filter and adjust your logs to be able to get the exact information you want. But if you're just looking for centralizing your syslogs, for instance, you can forward straight from Filebeat to Elasticsearch and leave out the Logstash part.
We have one more question, which is how to set up if we need to give two different input source to Logstash. The input section where we configure beats, we can configure multiple input sources for Logstash there. If you can drop me a mail, I'll send you the whole details about that from from the module we have used.
Yeah, and to add on to that, so you can give Logstash is really cool because you can do multiple inputs. You can do two or more even if you want to. And you can do multiple outputs, and you can do multiple filters. So you need to the Logstash config file that Srijit showed is the basis, but all of these components can be multiplied. So you can make it as advanced as you want. It's very common, for instance, for the syslog file beat to listen on both TCP and UDP ports, so that you can catch messages coming on in through TCP and UDP, and that's totally fine.
Any more questions? Okay, if that's all, you can email me any time about if you have any doubt on this. We have one more question. Which part?
I think he just means that he wants the slides of the webinar, and we will upload both the slides as well as the recording of this webinar to YouTube, and the slides will go to a slide share, and you'll receive an email later today or tomorrow about where to find those.
Okay. As I said, if you have any questions regarding the same, you can mail me or Walter regarding the same. I hope that this webinar was informative, and we look forward to have you in our future webinars also. Thank you so much, and have a good day.
Thank you.